Hello everyone, this is session number 16 in the Advances in Food Analysis and the Overview. The topic we'll be covering today is the overview of HPLC, High Pressure Liquid Chromatography. What is liquid chromatography? The history of liquid chromatography began at early 20th century. In 1906, a Russian botanist, Mikhail Twist, invented liquid chromatography in order to separate various plant pigments. He injected the plant extract and petroleum either through a glass column packed with the calcium carbonate. Since this was done on a glass column, he was able to observe the changes inside the column. At the beginning, there is only one layer of pigment on the top of the column, but as time passes by, the pigment is separated into four different colored layers. The research later discovered that those four layers were bluish-green chlorophyll, yellowish-green chlorophyll B, yellow xanthine, and orange carotene. The whole process of separation took several hours and thus is not a very practical method. This long analysis time was a part of the reason that liquid chromatography did not become a very popular analytical tool in the half century of Mikhail Twist's invention. Below is some commonly terms used in chromatography. Chromatography is a separation technique, and the word chromatography originates from the word chroma means color and graphene means write. Chromatograph is a separation equipment, and chromatograph is an output chart obtained from the analysis. What is HPLC? HPLC is a high-performance liquid chromatography. Before HPLC was available, liquid chromatography analysis was carried by gravitational flow of the eluent, thus required several hours of the analysis to be completed. Even the improvement added in later time were able to shorten the analysis time slightly. Those classical initial liquid chromatography systems are called low-pressure chromatography or column chromatography. The LC systems that Water Corporation developed using high-pressure pump that generates rapid flow of eluent and thus resulted in dramatic improvement at the analysis time. Compared to the low-pressure chromatography, the newer types were called high-pressure liquid chromatography. Therefore, it was used to be thought that HPLC stands for high-pressure liquid chromatography. However, nowadays, it is a common agreement that HPLC stands for high-performance liquid chromatography. Another big change from Twist's date was the data acquisition methods. Instead of observing the changes of layers by ice detector, system was coupled to the liquid chromatography and output was recorded on a paper chart. If we were to demonstrate analysis on a chart, initially HPLC system was referred to as Water Corporation system. Still now Water Corporation is a pioneer, HPLC pioneer, but there are several other companies that manufacture and sell HPLC. These are the components of HPLC, such as the solvent reservoir. The eluent is present into the solvent reservoir, then there's a degasser, there's a pump, then there's an injector which injects the eluent into the column, then there's a detector which detects the magnetic radiations, and then there's the electronic signals which are recorded into the recorder. The components of the HPLC are pump, injector, column, detector, recorder, gasser, column, heater. That's all for this session. Thank you.